Let's go into the crude oil. Okay, what we know to do, guys and gals, hey, Thomas, we know the first thing we do is we look at our trend filter. Our trend filter on crude oil is down. The trend filter is the magenta MA, moving average. We don't use moving averages for support and resistance, but we do like that moving average, that magenta moving average. When it's angled down, we love for it to what? We love for it to be angled down so we can take short opportunities. Now, I did touch the 50 MA. That's the only one, only support and resistance I like when the 20 crosses a 50 and you get a retest of the 50. That seems to be a continuation trade. So it did stop on the 50, but we just don't use moving averages for support and resistance, but it is confluence right there. But what we do is a simple replay the two videos we have on our website, daytradingthefutures.com, and it shows you how to trade a trend market and a chop market. So Gerald has those posted on our training videos under Day Trading the Futures. Please play that if you have a chance today or this week sometime. Play trend versus chop, because that's going to decide our bias. If it's angled down, the magenta MA is angled down, the trend bias is short. If it's angled up, the trend bias is long. If it's sideways or horizontal, get the chart, we are in a range chop market. I went over about a 20-minute video, 25-minute video on that, so play that. It says trend, trading trend versus chop. But if you notice, we are in a downtrend. So the easiest trade that we have to do is a break retest. It's called a continuation trade or an ABC pattern, a 1-2-3 pattern. Basically, what we're going to do is we're going to look for the market to break down through support, retest support, which is our retest, the old support, which would be new resistance, and that will be our ABC pattern. So our ABC pattern will look like this. There is the A right there. It broke down through the control point. Now the blue line, and I explained this in the last video too, if you want to play it, the blue line is the control point. That's the most volume that's been traded in crude this morning. So the beautiful thing about that level is that is going to be major support and resistance. It takes all the volume coming in from the hedge funds, banks, all the different professional traders, amateur traders, etc. And it's all derived, that blue line will show us where all the major volume is in the market in that instrument. That's that blue solid line. So that's naturally by itself going to create major support and resistance. So when it breaks with trend, the natural trade would be to trade the retest off of that. So we want to remember that, because the most volume is traded is a natural launching point for a trade. So we have to always keep that in the back of our head. But we know the retest of the control point was a beautiful trade. There we go. In a second. So that's the natural ABC right here, ABC. All we're going to do is trade with trend. If trend is down, we're just trading ABC pattern, shorts or longs. Now, your best ABC pattern from your, you see how we broke below and retested, is going to be a natural retracement. The retracement, the natural retracement is going to be 62 to 76% is going to be your sweet spot for the recent high. So you can see we were at a 62 to 76% retracement right there. I don't like taking retracements that shallow below 38% of the previous leg. So anything below this is bad news, because you're probably going to get stopped out. So anything below 38% retracement right there, you know, there's your big leg down, big 5-minute bar down. Here's your 30, 23% retracement, 38%. That is scary stuff, because you want at least minimum 50 to 76% retracement. It's going to be your sell zone where you're going to look for resistance. So the price, what happened is we broke down, we retested my sweet spot. And I look for this on news too. Once news released, seconds after news released, 15 to 20 seconds, I'll look for the market to gap down or gap up, and I'll look for a natural retracement between 62 to 76%. We like to trade that with a market delta pulling us in. But that's just a real great short this morning. So the solid lines are the most important lines on this chart. The solid lines are volume-based. I have four different profiles that I profile. My solid lines are the most important. That is volume profile. My blue being the most volume that's traded in that instrument, it's going to create natural support and resistance. The red and the green line, the red will be high value area, the low will be low value area. That is calculated based upon that blue line. Without that blue line, I cannot calculate the red and the green. So the green is low value area. You see price coming off of it right now after we scaled down here for this short. Price is coming off of that. So I know my next setup is going to be this. I know if I break through low value again, because our natural way to trade trend is break retest. I know if I break and I retest within a couple ticks, maximum three ticks, it's allowed to go through. It just can't close back inside it with the body of the candle. Then my natural trade is going to be a break retest like that, which is what? Another ABC. So my next setup in crude is going to be looking like an ABC pattern short again. So what I'll do is I'll watch if this trend's really strong, then it's going to set up, it's going to set up a ABC pattern short again. So when I'm looking at this and I want to see where the next possible inflection point is going to be, I want to look at volume profile and say, hey, where's my next pattern? There will be my A, it will break right through it. My B pattern will come down. My B pattern will come down, and then we'll look for a possible ABC short right here if it breaks, once it continue and break lower. And that's what you do with trend. Trend days are pretty easy because all we're looking, we know we got the major levels on here because my market profile will catch all the big ones because it is the major inflection points based upon volume. So we'll look for another ABC popping up at this level coming up. So we break through low value area, that's two times confluence. We have price profile and volume profile on top of each other. Now the dotted lines are, I said the solid lines are volume based. So the dotted lines will be what? It'll be price based. So if you look at my solid line down here, if I look at my solid lines, my LVA, my dotted line is my price based. It's more price based profile. So that's two times what's called stacked area. So I know if I get through that and I retest it, it's going to be major resistance, and I'm going to look for a negative market delta. Now let's look at this last setup, this ABC short up here. This last setup is just a beautiful trade. Let's look at the confluence we got on it. So what we did is we were in a downtrend. We know we're short in retracement, so we break through the control point, come down to the low value, find support, and come back up. Now, as we come back into resistance, look at the resistance we got. We got the blue dot, which is price control. We got the small green dots, which is my long-term low-value area. Long-term, this does not change. My small little dots do not change at all during the day. They're static. And then I got my control point, which is the most volume traded. These are the most important lines, the volume profile. So what I do as a trader is, on all these markets, I literally let my solid line set the trade up. I let volume profile set it up. And if I get extra confluence, which my price profile, my long-term profile coincides with it, that's called a stacked area. It just gives stronger resistance. So this is three times confluence short on this retracement. I got price control, which is blue. I got long-term LVA, and I got control points. That's three times short all by itself. But we also use the white chart. I use the white chart because I have another profile over here. So my black chart, like I said, I got volume profile or solid lines. My dotted lines are price profile, and my small little dotted lines are long-term profiles that don't move during the day. So that's my three profiles over there. If I come over to the white chart, I do the same thing. I use it as resistance. The best way to trade this white chart, I don't look at all these blue and red dots. They're irrelevant to me. I don't care about the dots inside a profile. I want to wait till where the market gives me an ABC pattern outside or breaking just back inside a profile. I want to let it break. I want to let it retest. And then I'm going to look for what? I'm going to look for a short pattern right off that chart when the Fibonacci dots fire, and I'll look for negative market delta over here. So right here is the same situation. What I'm looking for is an ABC pattern break outside. So when I trade this chart, it's a simple pattern, the same exact pattern. It's an A, and then a B, and then a C. So there's my A. Make it bigger so you can see it. Very easy to understand this methodology. We're taking trend. These are trend trades. There's A, B, simple ABC pattern short. Here's B. All right, there's your B. And then we have an ABC short pattern here. So you can see it's the same exact setup. So what I do is I let these two charts set the trade up, the white and the black. And then my far right chart is an order imbalance. That's market delta. So there's my ABC short. Look at the Fibonacci retracement. Take the last swing high to the swing low. is right at 62% retracement. Look how gorgeous that was, between 62 to 76% retracement, my sweet spot. There it is. So these two charts, you can see how they set it up together. I love trading this white chart when it breaks back inside a profile or outside a profile. This is with trend breaking outside of profile. Now this is my developing profile. So now at this last short that we had, I had four times resistance short, four times. You can't get better than that because I got all the profiles on these two charts. You can't get any other profiles. You cannot profile the market with any other profiles. I've got price. I got volume. Price has been around since 1985. Volume since 1994. I got developing and I got long term. I got every single profile out there. Now, if you look at normal market profiles, a lot of vendors sell, they're not the same profiles, are they? They're totally different levels because I take out a lot of volume that is unnecessary to profile these charts. That's why there's days where this chart will stop the market to the tick, these volume profiles. There'll be days that'll be right to the tick because it's that accurate. It's based upon all the volume coming in the market. So if I let volume profile and set it up, if I'm trend down, and I look for a simple break retest, a volume profile comes within a couple ticks of it. It's allowed, the wicks are allowed to exceed it. It just can't close the body of the candle, close above the control point. So here you can see it never closed above my green long term. That's just a wick. See, it didn't close of my price control right there. That's just a nice little retest. So that's one, two, three. Then on my white chart is four times confluence. You can't get better than four times stacked area on any market you trade. I don't care what you trade, any futures, any stocks, any currency. This ABC pattern works the same exact way with trend. So once these two charts set it up, I look for market delta. Now the far right chart is our market delta chart. Now what we use that for is we use the market delta to show us the buy or sell imbalance between the bid and the ask. We are looking at the internals of the market. This isn't my opinion. This isn't your opinion. This isn't a stochastics. It's stochastic. It's not a moving average, convergence, divergence, a MAC. It's not any other lagging indicator. This is the true internals. This is showing me that I had a negative market delta right here, right at my key retest of 62% retracement, right there. So that told me that is a short opportunity. Right when that bar closes red, when it closes red, okay, you can get into that short opportunity. Your stop loss is two ticks above the swing high. That should put your average live fill right around $130 to $120 loss per one contract, okay, if you get stopped out. Our maximum loss, no matter what, on crude and gold is 15 ticks. They move both $10 a tick, so you're not going to risk more than $150 per one contract no matter what. But we like to put our stop loss two ticks above the swing high on any given market, whether it be the S&P or whatever you trade. After you get a negative or positive market delta, then we like to scale our first contracts at our symmetry dots and then see if the runner can hold. So our first scale is down here at the symmetry dots to scale. That's our first scale point. And then we see if we can break the lows and continue. Okay? That's a simple way how to trade the system. We have the support reason, we have the trend with the trend filter, we have the resistance area with the market profile, and we got the entry with the market delta to your right. It's a simple, let these two charts set it up, and let market delta on the right enter the trade with small risk. And that's how you're gonna trade the system over and over and over again. It don't matter what market you trade, it's the same exact way, okay? So now if it goes into a second test trade, which it is now, there's a way we can get in without taking market delta for the first red bar. If you're gonna take a first red bar like this, if it closes red at a resistance, all right? If it closes red, then your stop loss is going to be two ticks above this enter at the next close of red bar, two ticks above the swing high, be your stop here. Your entry would be here at 52.73. Got as low as what? 52, 56, 57. 73 short, 57 was potential on this last trade, entering off the J signal chart off of a second test trade. So we're coming into a second test trade right now. If you close red, that's a possible entry in a second test. It's more aggressive than the first one with market delta. The second one is a possible red, close red. The reason you can use this chart instead of market delta for an entry is this is a momentum, more of a momentum chart. Second test trades are more dangerous than first trade, but we are in resistance. So what it lets you do, if you close red over here And if it closes green anytime while you're trying to get to your first target, you can close your stop. You can stop it out with a small profit. Take a 3-tick profit, 10-tick profit, 8-tick profit, right? 4-tick profit. Or if you close red, it closed green right away, you got to take a small loss because it should come down to your first target. Take a 3-tick loss, 5-tick loss. Try to risk $50 trying to make a $400 to $500 trade. So we can use that. I put that in my ebook, how we can use this as an entry chart on second test trades like this, okay, if it's an aggressive trade. If you don't want to take second test trades, guys, you really don't have to because first test trades are the best. They are the best. In fact, you can take a first test here and then just let it wait till it breaks 60 to confirm the downtrend and take the next ABC pattern short. Second test trade, which is doing right now, are more dangerous than first test trades because the first test trades are taking the amateur traders out or the wrongly positioned traders. So if you get, our goal is to get in on the first test trade, scale, and then see if that runner can run because there are days where you just scale, it'll go up a little bit, it'll take out the lows, and it'll run down another 40, 50, 60, 70, 100 ticks. So then you got to scale. What I like to do is scale 50% of my contracts on the first resistance supporter beam on the symmetry dots, and then I like to try to get to the third set of symmetry. Okay? So that's what we do, guys and gals. It's very simple. We're using these two charts to set up ABC pattern longs or short into resistance into stack areas. You don't trade unless market profile sets it up. In other words, I don't care about this market delta chart on the far right until I'm on top of market profile, period. Market profile sets it up. There's no trades unless market profile sets it up, period. No matter what, you got to let market profile, the internals of the market set it up. Once it comes on a retracement with overall trend direction back into that profile within two, maximum three ticks, you get yourself a trade set up. Okay?